the wheel this way, to your left.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's nice. That's the shot.
The 53 indicates what county it came from, and the license plate in all what town it was licensed in. So this one came from Normandy, and it was, I think, Arromanche.
What year is it?
This is a 1938 Bugatti Model 57.
Okay.
57. It was originally sold to a fellow named Trochan or Trochan.
What's the story about it when you got it, though?
When I got it, it was a non-running basket case. It had not been run for a number of years, maybe 20 or 30 years. And it had a seized engine, and it was in very, very shoddy condition. It had a water line across the center of the dash, indicating that at one point it had been underwater.
Wow.
It came out of a collection in Oak Brook, Illinois. A man named John Jumer owned it. And his collection was sold in entirety by another collector from Illinois named Joe Cantori. Joe Cantori subsequently sold off a number of cars that he didn't care to have. And this is one of them.
Where did the fellow in Illinois get this car from?
Cleaning nightmare.
I have no idea how Mr. Jumer came to obtain the car, but I believe he was the one who imported it from France. Restoration was done by Classic Auto Rebuilding, or otherwise known as L Cars, in Cameron, Wisconsin. And that was how the tail end originally appeared. Upholstery as it came apart. The engine as it came apart.
Little brads right through the leather into the wood.
So the whole sill here is all wood.
It's completely wood. You can see the joint from the same. Yeah, I see how to make the car unit. It
bear
meshes
claws.
With
what they call bear claws. I think
similar.
Some suicide doors had those.
Yeah. I never saw them just V's like this.
Close that door.
What?
Is
look right over here, you'll see this really modern building.
Uh-huh. That's something else.
Yeah.
There's it looks kind of almost like.
Yeah, it is. Everybody says that.
And this looking building in itself, but not for that location.
Yeah.
Thank you.
you a little bit about this as you kind of get close to it. This is a 3.3 liter, that's about 180 cubic inches, straight-eight engine with twin overhead cams. It puts out about 140 horsepower.
Wow. Twin overhead cams. This is all aluminum?
The cam cases are aluminum. It's a single iron block. This goes all the way down into the bottom of the engine. There's an aluminum oil pan underneath an aluminum tank. So the engine block is all the iron. It has no separate head. Everything is integral in one piece. And one piece casting.
Ingenious. And the carburation is a pain in the rear.
Yeah.
What about the carburation on the car?
The carburation is a Stromberg UUR2. This was the best carburetor available at that time.
Yeah.
They don't have the rear.
No, I didn't think so.